measurement. That is, we have to calculate what is meant by free space wavelength, what is meant by guide wavelength, what is meant by cutoff wavelength. Just we have to compare theoretical value and practical value of guide wavelength. Before starting off the experiment, right, here in this experiment, especially we are using frequency meter. You know how to operate this frequency meter. The other method is we are using this slotted end section. Slotted line section. Here the slotted line section having the main scale and auxiliary scale. Here the main scale contains from 6 to 90 centimeter scale and auxiliary scale is from 0 to 10 point. Here by varying the slotted line section, where exactly the 0 point in auxiliary scale is coincided with main scale is nothing but we have to calculate the distance. Calculate the distance. Here the method we are using to calculate the wavelength by using double minimum method. Double minimum method, that is where exactly the signal amplitude can be reduced. At that time we had to calculate distances by using slotted line section. Satellite section, right? Next move to the main experiment. Here already you know the precautions of the Claystone power supply. What are the precautions of Claystone power supply? The beam voltage should be minimum position, repeller voltage should be maximum position, meter select in V position, modulation in CW, and frequency and amplitude of AM and FM should be minimum positions, and HT should be off position. And must not should, before switching on the total setup, the fan should be on, cooling fan should be on. Why? Because the Claystone tube which generates high frequency signals, nothing but it generates high heat. To reduce the heat from in this Claystone tube, we are going for using cooling fan. Now start the experiment, switch on the power supply, next HT on, and directly displays B voltage, right? Now change the B voltage to 230 volts. And note down the beam voltage in your tabular column and note down beam current in terms of milliamps. After noting the beam current, go for repeller voltage. After changing the meter select repeller voltage, change the modulation to AM. Once we have to select amplitude modulation, we are going for increase the frequency and amplitude of the AM to be maximum. Now slowly varying this repeller voltage from maximum to minimum position, slowly varying up to first mode of a signal generated. Right, here the first mode of a signal is generated by using this repeller voltage. Once finding the first mode of a signal, now we are going for operate the frequency meter to find out the frequency first. That is, the relation is there, lambda value, which is equal to lambda equal to C by F. Your C value is constant. First we have to find out the frequency to calculate wavelength. That is, by varying the frequency meter in a clockwise direction up to first dip is coming. Right, now the dip is coming. So we have to find out the frequency by using this frequency meter where the two horizontal red lines and vertical lines is coincide together. Once it is completed, frequency is completed. Now we are going for slotted line section.
this slotted section moves from right to left. Whenever the moving from move from right to left, where exactly we are getting minimum of the signal? See, observe the CRO. All of you observe the CRO. Now I am rotating slightly, and see this one. Suddenly decreases the amplitude of a signal in the CRO. At that time, I have to note down. See this one. This is the main scale coincided with zero scale in axial scale. That is, this is zero is coincided with around here 12.6. That is, we have to note down D1. D1 is nothing but 12.6. That is zero in the axial scale is coincided with main scale. We have to go for matching together. This coincided point is D1. First distance. Next, again move here. See this one again. Amplitude is increases after again rotating, moving this scale. So again, the amplitude is decreases. Right here, see this one again. Where exactly amplitude suddenly decreases here in this axial scale? 0 points coincide with around 15.4 centimeter. That is, we have to measure two different distances, that is D1 and D2. That is, D1 is the first amplitude decreases point in the scale. The second one is, second distance D2 is measured in the, where exactly again the amplitude is increase and decrease. That is the point we have to calculate D1 and D2. That is the nothing but double minima method. Double minima method. Once finding this frequency on D1 and D2, D1 and D2 from slotted line section, I have to calculate and note down in your tabular column. That is beam voltage, note down beam current, repeller voltage, frequency you have to note down by using frequency meter, and D1 and D2, and calculate the free space wavelength lambda naught, which is equal to C by F. Calculate the lambda naught value and lambda C value and lambda G value, and lambda G both in theoretical and practical. Here, how to calculate the lambda naught value? The lambda naught, which is equal to C by F. Substitute C equal to C value and frequency, which how much we are getting. Substitute and find out this lambda naught value. Similarly, calculate lambda C. Okay, the lambda C is fixed value. That is, lambda C equal to 2A. A is constant. And substitute 2.286 in the place of A and find out the lambda C value. Next, we are calculate lambda G, that is guide wavelength in practical. That is, we are calculating D1 and D2 distance in the slotted section. Substitute D1 and D2 values, and finally we are getting lambda G 4.4 centimeters. But in theoretical, you know the equation is 1 by lambda naught square, which is equal to 1 by lambda G square plus 1 by lambda C square. Substitute in this equation, finally lambda G, which is why I am getting 3.89 centimeters in theoretical, but in practical we are getting 4.4 centimeter. This is the way to calculate the wavelength of a microwave signal. That is, we have to calculate free space wavelength, guide wavelength and cutoff wavelength, and compare guide wavelength for theoretical and practical methods. Thank you very much for attending this laboratory.